Welcome to Love Island's Under the Duvet. This is our weekly show with all of your insider gossip and exclusives you need in your life. I'm Emily Siegel, and if you have ever been personally victimised by Megan, then please contact our helpline, hashtag Under the Duvet. On the show today, our big question is, now there's newbies on the island, will Megan and Wes last? We also need to talk about, will Danny deal with Jax's ex being on the island? The lovely Theo joins us with his predictions, and on last night's bombshell, he's going to be talking about that. And we find out what all the celebs and the entire world have been tweeting, but it is time to find out who is under the duvet with me. It is Kendall! Kendall, known as being the first victim of Adam. I mean, like, wow, what is your take on what is going on at the moment?
It is crazy at the minute. I think, yeah, it's the curse of Adam, like, third girl now to be involved with him, out. And then the Wes and Laura and that situation, the mega, oh my goodness.
Yeah. Do you feel like now you're actually quite relieved watching it from the outside? Do you feel in a safer place?
Do you know what? It's nice to watch it from the outside, but it kind of makes me want to get back in there as well. Like, I want to get involved with it all.
We are going to talk more about that, actually. But before we get into the thick of it with Kendall, we go over to the news.
I'm Lydia with the Love Island latest, and 12 new islanders have arrived, and some of the most stable relationships could be at risk. Over in Castlemore, Jack's left uncomfortable by the arrival of his ex Ellie, and the other boys think she's pretty keen to get him back. Over at the villa, Georgia shuts the door on finding any potential new coupling, saying she'd be happy to introduce Josh to her parents, but he tells the lads his door's slightly ajar. Laura proves herself to be literally the most grown-up person in the villa, making up with Megan. It's after she realised Wes wasn't really for her. Oh, and the fact that six new boys have arrived, meaning she could meet someone new. And more than 200,000 tweets featured the name Megan yesterday. Whoever's running her Twitter account celebrating it, that's despite the vast majority of them dubbing her Muggy Meg, commenting on her transformation, or hoping she doesn't get to use hashtag Spawn anytime soon. That's the latest. Back to you, Emily.
Thank you, Lydia. Now, before we give Kendall her probing, let's remind ourselves of what Alex thought Ellie's favourite sexual position was. Viewers, warning, you may find this offensive. I'm sorry that you had to say that, Kendall. Right, Kendall, are you ready for your probing?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. How long do you think it will take Adam to hook up with a new girl, or do you think he'll actually be loyal and wait for Zara?
No, he won't be loyal and wait for Zara. I'm giving it 24 hours.
24 hours, that's actually very generous, I think.
Yeah.
Do you think Samira is a snake?
Yeah, I'm shocked. I didn't like how she made out she didn't know what was going on with the Megan thing to Laura.
I know,
and
she
like,
said
you told
I didn't
her to
coming.
Go for it, yeah.
Because you actually knew Samira, you were quite friends with
her. Yeah, I was really close to Samira. She made out she didn't know what was going to go on with Megan.
Do you think Jack and Danny will survive now that his ex is coming into the villa?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah,
I think it'll make them stronger. Yeah.
Are you surprised at Wes's behaviour?
I am.
Yeah.
Because he's genuinely a really nice guy. I just don't think he went about it the right way.
Yeah.
Parading Megan through the bedroom to the daybed.
That was so off.
A good move. Not cool.
Did you think you could see signs of him liking Megan before?
Maybe little signs. And I think that showed with how he was then with Laura.
Yeah.
Like, as soon as Megan came in, he was drifting from Laura a little bit. They were arguing quite a bit.
Yes, she did hide the arguments, I think.
Yeah.
Why does Megan hate Georgia so much?
I don't know. Georgia's just having a good time.
Yeah.
She's only young. She's 20.
Do you think jealousy? Do you think Megan's a bit jealous of Georgia?
I'm not sure. Maybe it's just because, like Megan said, she's not a girly girl.
Clearly not. Is Wes going to be Megan's number 38? I mean 21. She, 21.
21.
Do you think they're going to do it?
She's done it with Eyal, so was he 21?
Oh, yeah, that's a good point. No, I think he was 20. She counted him, didn't she? Yeah,
okay.
It was 20. So we can't see who's smoking in the villa. Who smokes?
Eyal smokes.
Does he?
Yeah, And he says that he's into like nature and he's the worst.
That is outrageous.
And Adam. Adam used to get in bed next to me.
Well, we knew that. Are you allowed to wear any of your own clothes in the villa?
Yeah.
Okay, so do you take your own clothes in there? Do they provide clothes for you?
You're sponsored by Misguided, so they send in a few little bits.
And what about hair and makeup? Do you have access to hair and makeup artists if you need
it? No, you have to do your own.
So there's like a rumour going around that there's a hairstylist, that's a
lie. Definitely not.
Okay, no. So all your hair looks so good. What about the old waxing situation? Is that before you go in the villa or...?
You just...
Do it yourself.
Yeah, you've got to shave while you're there.
Moving on, who would you right now want to be in the Do-Bit Society with?
Do you know what? I kind of have a thing for Sam.
Really? Yeah. The old bird man?
Yeah, I think he's lovely.
Yeah, he's nice. He's cute.
I shouldn't really say that because I'm going to be Samira's friend, but...
She's quite snaky herself. What do you think of Piers Morgan calling everybody on the island thick?
Oh, it's just Piers Morgan. He's not a fan, is he? So
really not.
No.
How much male attention are you getting now you're out, honestly?
A little bit more.
On a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being loads.
8.
Oh, okay. Good 8. What's the deal with you and Kim? We saw a sneaky kiss.
We're just friends.
Okay, friends that kiss. Is he a good kisser? No comment. Well, what about Rosie? Like, have you seen she's trying to muscle in?
Oh yeah. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with that. But I mean, first Adam.
Yeah. Oh right. Yeah. No. Terrible. She can't. Have you been offered any teeth whitening deals, Kendall?
No.
No. Really? No. That will come. And we are actually hearing rumours that you are going back into the island. Is that true?
I've not heard anything, but I actually would love to go back in,
Try and contact Casa Moore. They might have like a different manager or something. And lastly, who do you think is going to win?
Jack and Danny.
Yeah, Jack and Danny. Yeah. Thank you, Kendall. That was your Love Island probing. You were brilliant. Okay, now let's hear from one of our favourites from last year. He was also on the show last week, Theo, with his opinion on last night's bombshell.
Yes, guys, it's Theo Campbell from last season's Love Island. Quick cap on Love Island updates, okay? Can you believe what happened? Finally, Love Island starting to get really good. 3 weeks we had to wait for this, but yesterday's episode really put a massive, massive spanner in the works for a lot of the people in there, especially starting. It all started with Megan. Megan was the one who dropped a bombshell to begin with on Wes. You know, she asked for the kiss straight away. Wes backed away. If it was me, I would have went in straight away, but Wes on that front is a good guy, but then he flipped it round and proved he wasn't such a good guy after just dumping Laura and not really caring about her feelings at all. But at the same time, that was always going to happen because he's just a 20-year-old guy and she's a lot older than him, and they was never really going to match anyway. They were just forcing it from the beginning. So now that's happened. Very interesting for us to watch. Dumping from the island as well, Zara and EL getting left. I did not predict that one at all. I can't believe them two went. Good shout from the Islanders. I thought Megan might have went instead of Zara, but they've broken up Adam, maybe to get back at Adam or something, because he's been a bit unnice to everyone on the show. And EL, maybe they was using tactics that they'd done with Jess and Dom last year. Who knows? Newcastle, some more people coming in as well. I think that's going to throw an even bigger spanner in the works. I think one of the girls going in is Jack's ex. So we're going to see Jack and Danny get tested for the very first time, which is going to be very interesting to see. We're going to see how tonight's episode goes and more to come, more excitement, more drama. We'll see. Peace out.
Thank you, Theo, for your opinions. And don't forget, our big question of the week is, now they're newbies on the island, do we think Megan and Wes are going to last? Get involved with our hashtag, it's under the duvet. Also, comment below. Right, Kendall, we're going to talk about best dressed, worst looks. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Best dressed girl since you left.
Oh, thanks. I like Laura's style.
Yeah.
Yeah. She always
got
looks
good
cute.
Legs.
I like how she matches her little yellow shoes with her yellow earrings. I'm a fan of that. Yeah. Pink shoes, pink earrings.
Did you actually swap clothes in that? Like, were you all right with lending people clothes?
Yeah, we all lent each other. Yeah.
Best dressed guy in the villa?
That's a tricky one.
Yeah. Do you like Eyal's look?
I was just going to say, I like Eyal's look. I remember when we were in there, he came out first, second night in like a pair of like navy and white stripes, like they look like pajama pants. I was like, they are so comfy. Once you're done with them, can I have them? Because he's about my size anyway.
Well, EL does like to dress comfort over. Yeah. I mean, did you see yesterday he had the old like swinging joggers?
Yep, and the green ones, just chilling. Yeah,
not my usual type, but I thought actually, you know, you rock them.
Yeah.
Who do you think could try a little bit harder?
I just think Alex. Oh, I like how he asks everybody his like advice. Yeah. He comes out in his little pink Hawaiian shirt or his stripy shorts. It's just cute.
If actually you went on a first date with Alex and he turned up in that shirt, would you like go to the toilet and run away? Or?
I would never run away, but I'd be like, okay.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting.
Yeah.
Right, well, we now go over to Lydia for the best reactions of the week on Love Island, also known as I've Got a Tweet.
Hey girl, you better check your tweets.
That's just so muggy.
Love Island trends on Twitter every night, and we love to celebrate the best crafted or funniest bits we spot on there each week. Taking fifth, could Wondering Eye Wears strike again? You never know, there could be more happiness to be had. Fourth place is what we imagine as a fairly accurate image of Adam walking into Casa Amor.
Hi, how are you doing? We're back and we're ready for it all over again.
In third, it's official, Muggy Megan ain't getting no discount codes. In at number two, the many ways Megan's found to lose friends over the years. And while technically not a tweet, this week's number one goes to Danny with a Y dyer.
Probes, very quickly, can you just let everyone know what I'd do to Jack's flat if he got involved in the Do-Bit Society?
Yeah. Okay.
To the point and old, please. Yeah, bookshelf first. Lovely. Chair next, I fancy. Yeah, light. Shine the fucking light. Boom. Yeah, door. And then window. Lovely. And then the old desk. Beautiful.
You never know, we might have two Danny Dyers in the villa if Jack tries to join the Two-Bit Society. Tweet along as you watch at 9 o'clock, and you never know, you might feature in our charts.
I'm Emily Siegel and this is Kendall, and thank you for watching us. Don't forget, by Heat Magazine this Tuesday, we have an exclusive from Danny's BFF. I'll be back tomorrow morning from 6 with the Heat Breakfast Show with all your Love Island gossip in the bagel. And for all of your updates, follow us on Twitter at HeatWorld or go to our website, heatworld.com/love. Island. Before we go, let's remind ourselves again of what Alex thinks Ellie's favourite sexual position is. Please, viewers, if you are likely to find this offensive, turn away now. Don't forget to tune in every Thursday to Heat's Love Island Under the Duvet.
And if you've liked what you've seen, don't forget to hit subscribe.